And then what?
And then show me how it's 3 days and three nights.
Yeah,
answer.
No, you
from
tell
Friday
me.
To Sunday, how is it 3 days
how
and three nights?
How do you know
nights?
It's Friday?
When did you like?
I'm asking you.
Oh, wait, Friday. Do you celebrate
I'm
Good Friday?
I'm asking you. How do you know it's Friday?
Because the Sabbath comes on that day, which is Friday, evening, and that is when he was crucified in the afternoon.
Sabbath comes on Friday.
No, it's Friday night. Friday
you just said
Friday night. Friday. I said Friday night.
Okay.
Listen. By the way, do you admit you were wrong 3 days and three nights?
Cameron, tell
See,
me.
This is ego.
Tell me.
This is ego
Cameron, what you're saying.
Show me
that,
3 days
no,
and three nights.
That still doesn't make Muhammad a prophet.
No, show me 3 days and three nights.
Are you with me?
You know what he says?
Are you with me?
I'm with you. Are you with me?
Yes. That doesn't make Muhammad a prophet.
No, it makes Jesus a liar.
I'm asking you.
Because he says 3 days and three nights. Is there a false prophet?
Are you listening to me?
Or Jesus light?
That
which one is it?
Does he make
he
Muhammad
knows
a
he's
prophet.
Lost it now.
I'm asking
you. No, he knows it.
No, no, hold on.
He knows it.
Hold on. Does he make Muhammad a prophet?
Show him how Friday. I asked you a question.
I'm asking you. Does he make Muhammad a prophet?
3 days. Yes, Muhammad is a prophet.
Muhammad is a prophet of who?
Of the world.
Of the whole human being.
Thank you very much.
Allah now,
of
the world.
Are you going to answer anyway? Are you
going to answer?
Listen, listen. This man,
no.
By the way, this man here, he was making fun that the Prophet ﷺ did not prophesy anything. I asked him to show me the prophecy where Jesus says 3 days and three nights. First he denied, he did not say 3 days and three nights. And we read it to him from Matthew chapter 12, verse 40. Verse 39 onwards, okay? And wait a minute. When we asked him, how is it 3 days and three nights from Friday to Sunday? Yes? Okay, go on. Show me the counting system, please.
Any part of a day and night counts as a day and night.
Okay, when that's good, that's good. No problem. No problem. So how is it 3 days and three nights from Friday to Sunday? Please count it for us. To Sunday before the sun rose. Sunday before the sun rose.
And then Sunday.
No, no. Before the sun rose, the stone had already moved away. And Jesus, according to the Bible, had resurrected. So he died on Friday afternoon.
Yep.
Let's give it one day.
Yes. Okay.
Wait, wait, wait. Hear me out. Friday afternoon, one day. Friday night,
one night.
Saturday,
one day.
Morning, that's one day. Wait. Sunday night,
two nights.
Two nights. On Sunday, he had already risen. This is before the sun came out. Wait. Even if we give them. You got to listen.
Jonah was alive.
But how is it? Listen. You said even the part of the day or part of the night is counted as a day and night. So far we have counted 2 days, and I'll give you even the third day. That's fine. Show me the third night. Because on Sunday, before the sun rose, Jesus was up already.
John chapter 20 tells you that.
First day of the week, which one? First day of the week is Sunday.
Mary Magdalene went to the tomb.
Yeah.
And
tomb is empty.
Stone had been removed.
They had it all over.
Who finished this tomb?
They said.
In this generation.
There was another one in this generation.
Will not pass away. And he will come back to them. Sorry, who's in this glory?
I did an ascender to my God and your God.
No, no. Before we go there, I want you to tell us. Yeah. Show it to us how it is 3 days and three nights from Friday to Sunday.
Yes.
Sunday before the sun rose.
Yeah.
Please.
Yeah.
Okay, a Friday evening, Saturday, and then Sunday before.
Yeah, how many days have you got and how many nights?
Yeah, 3 days and three nights.
We didn't measure the night.
This says 3 days and three nights. He said 3 days and three nights.
How did they measure it?
I just read it to you. 3 days and three nights.
How they measure it?
Okay, show me how they measure it. Go on.
If it's part of a day, then they called it a day and a night.
Okay, so where is the third night? Show me the third night then.
This is how we know.
Where is the third night?
Just admit it's wrong.
I want you to show us where is the third night.
Just admit this wrong.
I've just counted to you 2 days. Sunday morning, before the sun rose, he was up. So where's the night?
Jesus says, no sign.
Where's the night on Sunday?
Only the sign of Jonah.
Sunday morning, before the sun rose.
Yes, exactly. So where is the night?
Part of the day.
It wasn't 3 days.
Okay, so part of the day, that's fine. No, I'll give you that as well. Where is the night then? Where is the night? The third night, where is it?
Counting system.
Yes.
Part of the day.
No, no, you cannot call a day and night. Come on. Jesus wouldn't say 3 days and three nights. He would only say 3 days then. The fact that he said 3 days and three nights is showing you that days and nights are different in counting.
Not
Look, look. You either admit that Jesus' prophecy failed, or you show us how can you account for 3 days and 3 nights. She doesn't want to listen now. That's fine. No problem. See, this is what happens. When they try to ask us where the prophecies are, all right, we give them the answer. But when we ask them for the prophecies in the Bible, it just shows that they don't want to discuss it. They're not interested
we're
in it.
We're telling them that he saw the devil.
Why would the Quran begin with A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim? Yes? Curse on the shaitan is in this particular. If the shaitan had indeed revealed the Quran to Muhammad, the first thing wouldn't be cursing him, would it? It doesn't make sense. Throughout the Quran, the shaitan is cursed.
Why would he call himself an enemy?
Yes. Aduwwun Mubeen, Allah says in the Quran, time and again, Aduwwun Mubeen, he is one of your clearest and greatest enemy. They don't have, the point is they only read Islamophobic websites and they come here and they try to basically use that whatever they have learned by hearsay or on some Islamophobic website. They don't research it thoroughly.
What's that?
Not in the sense of worship Allah Almighty. Yeah, not in the sense. So at the end of the day, you cannot show us 3 days and three nights.
Yes.
How? Show me. Show me, go on.
The way they counted days and nights was part of a day counted as a day and a night.
When you say day, you mean the Jewish people?
So Jesus died on the Friday before sunset.
Okay, one day.
One day.
Yeah.
Saturday and then Sunday morning.
No, don't fast forward like that. Count the days and nights for me. Friday, he died. That is one day.
One day.
Okay, one day and one night. Fine. Saturday, we got one day and one night. So far, we got 2 days and two nights. No, where is Sunday one night? Because before the sun rose, he had already risen. Where is the night come from?
That if it's part of a day, in the first century, you just described it as one day, one night.
In the first century, did they have a 24-hour day?
They described, yes, they did, and they described part of a day as one day and one night. It's just
so you're saying happened. You're saying a day can be night as well.
And this is one of the ways. Are you
why does the verse say day and night? Why does the verse split it?
Can
they were there at
you're not
the time,
you're not even listening to the question.
And it was not written down by somebody who was born 600 years later.
By the way, this is Jesus. Jesus is the one who's saying 3 days and three nights. He didn't say just 3 days. No. If you said that, yes, she got a point. But he says, he said 3 days and three nights. So far, they showed us 3 days. Where's the third night?
Why don't you just admit it?
Counting system.
Counting system for you is wrong, because for you, a day and night are the same.
Later.
Exactly. Why did Jesus say, look, even 2,000 years later we got day and night, Alhamdulillah. We have day and night even today. And we had day and night back then. When Jesus clearly says 3 days and three nights. Don't go to Muhammad every time you're cornered. Every time the Christians are cornered, they jump to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Why do they do that? You know, why do you compare your God to my prophet? Why do you always do this? Every time we see the weakness of Jesus, they go to Muhammad, because subliminally they know that Jesus is a man, and the only way they can compare a man is to another man, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Why do not compare your God to my man? Sorry, my prophet.
We compare our example of Jesus Christ, our Savior and God, the example of God, to your prophet, who is
you're doing it again. You're doing it again. If Jesus was your Savior, listen. If Jesus was your Savior, then why did he himself never claim to be God?
That is what Muhammad says.
Now I'm asking you from your Bible. Show me from your Bible.
We tell you each week.
Okay, show me in the Bible where he claims to be God.
That's Jesus at trial. Yeah. Pilate.
Yeah, what did he say?
Pilate says, are you the Messiah, the Son of God? And Jesus says, yes.
He doesn't say yes. That's a lie.
He didn't say yes.
He says, so you say. So you say.
Okay, wait a minute. So you're telling me.
On the clouds of heaven.
Yeah.
You're making up your own verses.
He
said, let's read it.
No, no, before. Are you saying that? Are you saying that anyone who comes on the clouds is God? Is that what he's saying?
Jesus would have avoided crucifixion, avoided having to die for your sins.
He never said. By the way, what makes Jesus from what you said? What makes him God? Because you said he said he's a Messiah. That's fine. You. Being Messiah doesn't make you God automatically.
Shall we see what? Yes, he says, tell us, are you the Christ? That's the Messiah.
Yeah, Christ
the
is the Messiah.
Son of God.
Yes.
Yes.
There are the sons of God. Doesn't matter.
As you say. As you say.
Sorry, he didn't say yes.
Wrong.
And Jesus replied, I say to all of you, in the future you will see the Son of Man, which he called himself.
Yeah. Daniel was called the Son of Man.
Son of Man, Son of Adam. Son of Adam.
On the clouds. So that
no, Son of God, Son of Man, yeah?
Daniel's.
No, no, Daniel himself is called Son of Man. By Gabriel.
Son of Man was worshipped by all nations.
Was Daniel called the Son of Man?
Now, when they heard this,
that's a,
the Jews reject him.
She will not answer. That's the thing, you know. Having a conversation with this lady, it goes into a preaching
Jesus
mode.
Jesus is saying he is God.
No, he never said he's God. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. He never said he's God. Jesus, if you read in John 5:30, he says, I, by myself, can do nothing. Does that sound like God to you? No, it doesn't. Jesus said, I do not know the hour. Does that sound like an ignorant person or God? A person who does not know something is ignorant. Jesus did not know the hour. God is omniscient.
Misunderstood it, then Jesus would not have been crucified.
Listen, Jesus was crucified not because he claimed that he was God, because he was claiming to be the king of the Jews, and this was a threat to the Romans.
You have heard the blasphemy. This is what they say.
Who says? The Jews. Exactly.
Absolutely.
So the Jews will call him a madman, you'll believe that. The Jews will call him a magician, you'll believe that.
Then they
come on.
His face and struck him with his fists, and others slapped him, mocking him, prophesying, just as you are.
Where the question I asked you was, where did Jesus claim to be God? And all you did was you went into preaching mode. You did not show us a single verse. You did not show us a single verse which claim where Jesus claims that he's God. Are you going to run away? That's it. Okay, that's fine. No problem. Are there any other Christian takers here?
I'll take you.
No. Oh, assalamu alaikum.